Hi viewers, welcome you all for CAN Academy. See, this is what the sound of 3000 horsepower car. Okay, so these are WhatsApp group, as you many people you know can also join if you are interested to join in this group. So agenda of this tutorial is very two important service IDs in the unified diagnostic service, that is write data by identifier and read data by identifier. Yes, so I have mentioned the two write and read in the same tutorial, you'll understand. See, in this tutorial I gave some assumption scenario given by car manufacturer. Okay, see, we are working in a project, so the project car manufacturer, that is the end customer, they gave some assumption, they gave some requirement. Okay, so what requirement says? Client wants to write and read ECU serial number. So he wants to write and read the ECU serial number in a specified DID. Okay, so he gave some preconditions also. What are the preconditions? Write and read should work in extended session. As you know, three sessions in the diagnostic session control. So he want it to be written in a extended session. Then write and read service should be secured. So security access should be implemented for this particular ECU serial number module. Then the security timings of unlocking ECU should be 150 seconds. Yeah, this also he have given. So the security should be accessed only with 150 seconds. After 150 seconds, it should automatically disable. Okay, the disable means it will automatically lock the processor or ECU. So the data he have given, see, this one data identifier, he give ECU serial number, and for this ECU serial number he give the DID also. So he want in this DID only you have to write this serial number. Okay, so see, the DID is 918B1, then the ECU serial number is 97646612. Of course these are WhatsApp number. Okay, so it's not an issue. Then this is a assumption scenario. I guess you understood this scenario. Okay, so you want to read and write in extended session with secure. The security accesses should be 150 second, and they mentioned the data, that is serial number and date identifier also. Now we'll go to the how to write this in the ECU. See, before writing, you just look on the introduction on write data by identifier. So write data by identifier, I have already covered in one tutorial. You can go back to that and you can see also. So I have made here in a very simple way. So this service is used to write some data with reference as an identifier. So no sub function used for this service. So possible uses of this service is configuring some information like ECU number, VIN number, chassis number, you can write. Then clearing non-NVM memory. So if you have any NVM memory, you can clear with some dummy data. Then resetting values. Resetting and clearing more or less same. Then setting content values. If you have some calibration values, you can set through write data identifier. See, this is another important one. ECU may, it's also in interview perspective also, you may get this question. So you cannot write or read all the date, all the dates. Because some OEM, they already mentioned some fixed, that is hard coded values in that DID. That DID you cannot able to touch that. So it will show you the warning. That is what this write data by identifier limitation, not a limitation, some restriction. Okay. Then, so now how it is work on the request and response wise. See, as per the client requirement, we want to test whether the code is written with extended. First extended session should be opened. Yes, I got the positive response for the extended session. If you are a first viewer or sorry new viewer to this video, better you can go to previous tutorials like what is a extended diagnostic session control, then what is security access. If you come, then it would be more helpful. So because I cannot able to explain everything in this, like extended session I cannot explain here, and security access, so better go back to this previous tutorial if you not watched that. Okay, so extended session, I guess ECU acknowledge that you are in extended session by giving positive response. Then now security access requested. again security access also unlocked, that is security unlocked. So in this security access also we need to send a seed. So once you get the seed, you'll get a key. So I got some comments, I got some mail, like regarding, can you please explain how seed and key works regarding security access. That also we are working on. So probably next video onwards, remaining UDS service should be in practical way how it is. So see, we are writing. So this is the data we are writing. 07 is a PCI length. This is PCI length. See, we have written seven bytes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then 2E is a service ID, that is write data by identifier. 91 and B1 is a did what client gave, that is sorry, what car manufacturer gave. And this is the serial number what they given. See, here I have mentioned the serial number with limit to one frame. In general, you will have n number of data you have to write. For example, you may write serial number for 40 bytes or 50 bytes. At the time, you have to use flow control with consecutive frames. That I will discuss in next video. That will be very far, very short. I will upload. So hereafter, I will upload the videos in very fast track way. Okay. So here, this is one frame. This is one 8-byte data. There is a PCI length, then service ID, again did, this is a serial number as a data. So we have written, then ECU should acknowledge now it will acknowledge, yes, the data, that what are the data you have written, which is written in the 91B1 did. So it acknowledge. So that's it about write data by identifier. Okay, see, easy, see, serial number is 97646612. Then this is a data identifier. Then 2E and 6E is 0703 is PCI length. Then 2E and 6E is service ID. Yes. So we continue with this. See, once we have written data, EC serial number into the ECU. Now we want to retrieve the data. So how to retrieve that? For that we need read data by identifier. So this is also more or less same. So you used to read the data from ECU. The reference is a specified identifier. No subfunctions used for this service. Security access may or may not be implemented for this service in as per ISO. But our car manufacturer, he need security access to be implemented. Okay. So here also some did restricts to read the data. Okay, so read data by identifier is a service ID 22. Same. Yes, extended session done. So we acknowledge you are in extended session. So security also requested and easy unlocked. See. So this is a read service. So 0322, and we know in this did only the ECU serial number is there. So we requested this data identifier. So I got one query like how to read ECU serial number using CAPL. So in simple way, if you are a beginner in CAPL, it's fine to write a CAPL program that you want to include this did. That's it. So you have to follow the same procedure. Like you have to, as per the requirement, if you are in extended session, if you want to be in extended session, give a command for extended session, then unlock the ECU, then use this this kind of same way in the CAPL, but sending these kind of bytes. Once if you send, you will receive this can see. So what are the data we have written, we are getting, see, in 91B1 identifier. One more thing I forgot is this is a 2-byte identifier. Okay, 91 is 1 byte, B1 is 2 byte, second byte. So 2-byte identifier. So in this 91 and B1, the data present is 97646612. So now we read the ECU serial number. So this is what practical way in real time working. So in my next tutorial, that is remaining three service ID remaining in unified diagnostic service, that I will explain in how it works in real time, like either in canalizer or cano, how it works. So, and moreover, I'll upload the capital tutorials regard with this ECU serial number, because the capital I'm holding because you have to understand something, how manually the things work, so then you can easily understand how it is in a scripting way. So that's what I'm keeping on hold. So if you like, again, like. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. And if you have any comments or query, can please comment. We'll get back as soon as possible. Thank you for watching. Catch you in next video.